Boys and girls, welcome back. Tone King here, coming at you live from the Tone Lounge. So, Mr. Jeff Diamond of DBZ Guitars Diamond Amplification sent this over. I had a look at it. This one here is his latest and greatest Kickstarter campaign. This one here is the dual amp selector. This actually here is the prototype. You could see over here, this is a collaboration with him and Mr. Bob Bradshaw of Custom Audio Electronics. And I asked Jeff, I was actually on my way to a mini vacation with my family, and I said, can you send it over? Can I check it out? And he said, yes. So I was happy to have checked this out. I didn't really do a demo. You saw that on his video. I'll include the link below. Actually, it's in the Kickstarter campaign, so check it out if you want to see a demo. But I do demos all the time. So I was like, let me check one of these out. And again, he was kind enough to send it over, so I had a go. And I just wanted to get the camera roll and tell you a little bit about it from my perspective. So this one here is kind of like a half rack space, you know, kind of a full rack would be, you know, about yay big. So half rack space, which is nice if you put some feet on it, fit nicely on top of an amplifier. And it toggles two amps. I actually made some notes. So I'm gonna read you a little bit of a cheat sheet, a high end amp switcher. The high end is important because this is, you know, USA made, you know, all high quality components. Anybody that knows Custom Audio Electronics knows that it's, you know, you're getting good stuff. Bob Bradshaw is known for, you know, kind of best of the best. You know, he does all the pro tour rigs, pro rigs of all the pro musicians. So this one here is a collab with him and Mr. Diamond. This one here also switches between tube and solid state. Okay, so this is a prototype, as you could see on there, prototype number one, but you'll have a tube and solid state switch somewhere on here. It's not on here now, but it will say tube and solid state, so you could buy one unit to do tube and solid state, which is kind of cool. This one here is also safe if you have trailing effects. There are some other units on the market that say that you can't do trailing effects. This one here you can. So if you wanted to use this live, so let's say you have two amps and you have your solo amp, that you're doing lead and it has some delay in the effects loop, and then you switch over to, let's say, your clean amp head or whatever the case may be, you know, that delay is trailing. And that's okay. If you use that unit, that's okay. You could still send signal to the amp head that has load on it, you know, that's not active. So that's kind of cool. It's safe for those kind of situations. Let me show you the back over here. So again, this is a prototype, so bear with the, well, you know what? This is what prototypes look like, so enjoy it. So you can see on the front, there's, you know, amp one, amp two, which is like that, with the active input, which is a buffered input. You also have a non-buffered input over here, which says passive. You have a direct output, which is kind of cool for like recording, if you actually want to do recording. You have two cabinets that'll run in parallel. What's cool about that is, so let's use the full stack example. Let's say you have a full stack, each cabinet being 16 ohms, so you have an 8 ohm load. So you plug one of these into your straight, one into your slant, and then what you do is you set each amp head to 8 ohms, and you feed it into this unit. And it's real simple. If you look over here, you have amp, you have return, return, send, send. So amp one, send, goes to the input of the amp. And then amp one return is the output of the amp going into here. Send goes to the input of the amp, and the speaker output goes to the return. So amp one, send, and return. And if I go like that, same thing. Amp two, send goes to the input of amp two, and the output of amp two goes to the return. Here's your parallel for speaker cabinets. And then you have a switch. So if you want to do, you know, live switching instead of doing this on stage, I'd probably do that for demos and stuff. But if you want the foot switch, you can actually have a foot switch right over here to do that. So it's pretty robust, you know, made in USA, all metal enclosure. Let me see if I got everything. So high end amp switcher, tube solid state, safe if you have trailing effects, direct output, which is kind of cool. Two cabs in parallel, made in the USA. So some benefits if you're at home and switch heads without the hassle, you know, one cabinet type of thing. If you want multiple tones for live situations, or if you want to use a backup, you know, a lot of time, you know, especially tube heads could be finicky. And if you're playing live and depending on that head, but you're a little nervous, you could have a second head at the ready with something like this. And last but not least, it's also expandable. So you could get another one of these for every every one that you add, it adds another head. So this here is two, and if you add another one, you'll get three heads. If you add another one, you get four, okay? The price on here, so for the Kickstarter, really, it's the first 20. The Kickstarter, you know, the goal for the Kickstarter really covers the first 20. So the first 10 will be for $299, and then the second 10 are $349. The street price on this will be $399. So first 10 saves $100, and the second 10 will save $350, and pretty much at that point, they'll almost be at the goal on the Kickstarter. And then there's some other cool stuff he has. Rig consultations, guitar amp survival kit. You definitely want to check that out. Limited edition Nitrox, etc. So, you know, I really enjoy supporting Jeff's stuff. You know, Jeff and I do guitar gear tech talk. He is a tremendous wealth of information, and I'm happy and proud to have him kind of co-featured in that segment, Guitar Gear Tech Talk. And he had been talking about this one for a while, so I really wanted to check it out. And more importantly, I wanted to make sure everybody knew that this thing existed. Wouldn't this look real nice, kind of like, kind of in the backup over there? So that is it. So I will include the links below for the Kickstarter campaign. Definitely check that out. And Jeff does a whole other video that talks about this bad boy right here. So thank you for watching my video. Leave you off with one of those. Until next time, rock on. Later.